Hi children, how are you all? Welcome to my English channel. Okay, hope you are having a nice time watching the videos. Yeah, hope I'm not boring you with the videos. Yeah, fine, thank you. So this is the third module of your second chapter. Okay, now before going ahead with the class with this video, I will do a quick recapitulation of what we learned in the earlier class, in the earlier video. Okay. So in the last video we learnt about how to find the instructions, how to enact on the instructions written in an experiment. We learnt about various kinds of experiments like how to blow bubbles. Then we learnt about how to make a bubble painting. We also saw how to make a mix of oil and water, how to separate the skin and get the water and oil mixed together. So these are the things we did in our last class. Now today we will learn about a few more experiments. Now you look at these pictures. Okay, there are a few pictures of flower, a vegetable, you know, celery, then flower, a carnation given. Now what do you mean by celery? As you see here, the picture of spinach, or take coriander, that's given. What is a celery? It's a vegetable with long white or green stems which you can eat without getting it cooked. Okay, it's edible without having cooked. Fine. So you can also see a flower or a carnation. What is a carnation? It is a white or a pink or red flower with pleasant smell. Any white, red, pink flowers with pleasant smell will actually fit the bill of this experiment. You have to get this white flower to show the change, to show how the plants are absorbing water. Now look at these pictures. After seeing these pictures, what does it seem? What are we going to learn? What do you think? How to grow things? What is this experiment about? How to grow things? Or is it about how to water plants? Or is it about how plants absorb or soak up water? Now look at the equipments, or you know, the things needed for the experiment. Look at them carefully. What are there? As I told you, a jar of water is there, celery, then flour, you need tap water, and you need some dye, some food dye or color, food color. Okay, now we will come to the experiment a little later. Now let's speak about how many syllables or caps does each of these words contain. Say celery. I told you before how to calculate the how many syllables you have in a word. You have to, you know, the number of times your jaw is dropping, that gives you the number of syllables. Say for example celery. Say la ri. Your jaw is dropping three times, or say la ri. So there are three syllables. In white, when you say white, your jaw is dropping only once, or you can clap once. So the word white has one syllable. Let me write down the number of syllables against each. This will make your drop easier. Celery, as we saw, say la ri, three syllables. White has one syllable. Now see how many syllables does this word absorb have. Absorb, so two syllables, or you can absorb, so two syllables. How many syllables does the word vegetable have? Vegetable, four syllables. Flower, 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 two syllables. See, flower, two. Experiment, experiment, four syllables. So in which word do you find the maximum syllables? See, in vegetable, experiment, both this word have the maximum number of syllables, that's four. Okay, this is how you get the number of syllables a word is broken into. Now look at the picture here, it's given, and read the instruction chart. It is on how plants absorb water. Put the pics in the right order. Say what each step is all about. Look at these pictures. Remember, when you speak aloud for others to hear, you have to follow these few
things. Number one, stand up tall. Number two, look at the people you are speaking to. Number three, take a big breath and smile. Number four, speak loudly and clearly. Don't rush, as I am telling. See, I'm not rushing. I'm going about each and every instruction very slowly so that you can understand. Next, try to use any special words about the topic, any keyword related to the topic. Now, see the pictures, okay? And you have to correct the order in which the experiment is going about. Use the sentences to match the pictures, which comes after which. The celery and the leaves will turn blue. Drop a few drops of blue dye into the jar. Make water. Make notes about what you see. Put some water into a jar and then put white celery with leaves in the jar. So you see, let me put these instructions in order. Number one, put some water into a jar. That's number one. Next, drop a few drops of blue dye into the jar. Number two. Number three, put white celery with leaves in the jar. Number four, the celery and the leaves will turn blue. Then number five, make notes about what you see. So basically, you put some water in a jar, okay? Then put some food color, preferably the color blue. It will give you good results, okay? So put color, the blue dye, into the water, and then put this celery with leaves into the jar, okay? Then now, since you have put some dye, some colored water into the water, you will be able to see that the plant is absorbing water. The water is blue in color, so you'll get an idea of, you know, how much time it's taking to absorb the water. So you slowly you'll see the stems, the leaves, they're turning blue in color. You make some notes. Now normally this experiment takes time. See, this is the jar, this is the water. You have to make it blue in color, you know. You have to add some blue dye to make it blue in color. Put some celery in it, okay? Leave it for some time and then you find the leaves are turning blue, okay? It might take 1 or 2 days, but it will slowly turn from light blue to dark blue. This experiment takes time to work. Wait 1 day and then, you know, look at this, look at the celery, take some notes. Wait for 1 more day, take some more notes. Now, 1 day at a time you take and keep on writing notes. You'll see the color, you know, the color slowly, the leaves are gaining color, okay, from light to dark, as I said. Write the day, the time, what you see in words, what you see in pictures, and what you think is happening in a chart, in a diagram like this, which is given below. This is called observation. Okay, jot down the observations in words, phrases, not whole sentences. Okay, now this was about today's class. You try this experiment. It's a very easy experiment. You try this at home and this will be your task. You know the equipments. You follow the instructions. Follow what is necessary one after the other. And leave it for a few days and see if the plant you're working on, it how fast it is absorbing color. Okay, so that's it for today. You do your tasks and we'll meet again in the next class. Bye-bye, children.